children, Mr. Love Smith.
Amen.
Amen.
To the Bishop of Ceremonies once again, to my pastor, to each of you. I just want to say that I'm just glad to be here today. And if I just have one wish, it would be that our youth keep going forward. And also that this next year, we're going to make it a little bit better. And the year before, we want to have some choirs here. We're going to start going out. We're going to start doing some things. We fall a little bit out of waste at this particular year. And so next year, or starting actually this Sunday, I'd like to encourage our youth and all of us to start to work harder together so that we can make our youth really strong, really a force here in the youth power world. So once again, thank you.
Amen.
Everybody stand.
Come in.
We can see them a little around here. They lock them up, you know. So, see them a little. We are now at Shoney's, our first morning stop on
by my way to the big convention in Tampa, Florida. Everybody knows this is Pastor Smith's favorite eating spot. So we are all here at Shoney's. More to come. It's in Atlanta, Georgia. See when I get them This is not only a picture, this is a video that I'll be able to keep forever. Oh yeah, I get everybody. Amen.
past my life to get saved a woman's life. Thank you.
Look at me.
Thank you.
Hello, you're on live TV here at the convention.
Okay.
Make sure you get me. You get me.
And my.
Okay.
And there's a.
And me.
I love you.
I'm sorry you couldn't make it.
I love you now.
Did you get me up here? You heard me.
Look, Mike is a hero.
And we just found ourselves a new hero. He just saved a woman's life. And
they will burn a woman life.
Anyways, which we have a new hero here. I think you need to write this in the newspaper. Thank you.
Good morning, Miss Uncle Lee.
Hi. Bye. See you later. Could you remind that so I can see myself on tape? I told, and then, and plus I can't go now because she's not paying my way anyway. I probably can go though. Okay, here's the tree this little girl was on, who Mike has just rescued, about to climb over and bust her little head. Which you see, it's dangerous over here and whatever. Thank you, I gotta go.
I guess I'm in Tampa Bay, Florida. I guess that's wrong. All I know is I'm in front of
This is Dillard's.
I'm in front of Dillard's. That's all I know. I don't know what's there. I don't know if I'm in Florida. I don't know if I'm in
Tampa Bay.
I'm somewhere.
I'm sorry. Sorry, but
okay, let me get somebody's out of here.
Praise the Lord. pray for our children.
Thank you.
Providence.
We challenge you to continue to be the servant that you are and the servant that God would have you be. We love you with an undescribable love. With an undescribable love. And we bless you this day.
Tonight we take the time to honor a woman who truly fears the Lord.
President Kareem has shown up and truly shown out for the Lord. She had let the Lord direct, she has let the Lord direct her footsteps and led this Youth and Children's Convention to another level of first class. I'm happy tonight to say that I have served under her leadership of President Kareem. President Kareem, we thank you. We thank you for your leadership, your prayers, your friendship, and your faithfulness to serve as our president. You have really touched my life. And we, as the National Youth and Children Convention, would like to wish you the best in whatever or wherever you do, or what God directs your life to be. We love you, thank you, and we adore you. On behalf of the Youth Officers, thank you.
Number up to 200 animals of all different ages. They live in a well-organized society ruled by the more dominant adult. Now, coming up to either side of the train, the black and white colored animals you see are a herd of grand zebras. Like human fingerprints, no two zebra markings are alike. They'll seek shelter from their chief enemy, the lion, by mingling with other grazing herds, such as the orange, wildebeest, and the ostrich. Those large, light brown colored animals you see are inland antelope. Though he carries the nature of the one of the people, I already said them, they were back there away.
Love you and I die always. Everything in life could never live without you by my side. And I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong. And I grew strong. And I don't have you long.
To leave to make this long journey back to St. Louis. This is the area where we were living. This is the hotel that we were staying in, the Master's Inn. And look at this great crowd from St. Louis. There's the main man doing what he do best. There are the main women doing what they do best, gossiping. Plotting their course back to St. Louis. Favorite watering hole, Shoney.
Come on in, everybody. Breakfast on Uncle Lee this morning.
Thank you for showing me when I'm
here. Breakfast on Uncle Lee this morning.
Hi, bye.
Everybody,
okay, hello. We're back live on News Channel 5 with just saved a girl's life. Even though we're leaving from Florida, I'm sorry, but we must have been on a long commercial break. Well, anyways, here's Michael, our hero. How did it feel to be a hero?
It feels real bad.
Oh, no. Oh, it feels real bad.
Does anybody want to? Anybody got
it? It feels real bad, but a hero has just saved the day. Thank you.
Hey, anybody want to say anything to Aunt Levy on here?
I do. Oh, yeah, and hi, Mrs. Bobby.
We love you.
We love you, Aunt
Levy. Aunt Levy, who's going to be the superstar of all the superstars in Florida? The professor, Reverend Jim, Reverend Roscoe, any of Chinese ice.
Sure. Brad.
Yeah, right.
All right, that we got. We.
Ain't Love it. How
are
you
doing? Ain't Love it. I can make a reminder to say something.
Ain't Love it. Here it is. I'm going to give you one. Okay?
I'll give you one.
That's crazy.
I'll give you one.
Just one, okay?
You be fine.
No, I'm taking pictures.
Ugly, get that. Yeah.
But look at that head.
Well, I'm sorry. Well, she's just in grade right now. You're going to have to come back another time.
The twins are
that I just made up.
Well, look at that head.
Are you kind of
you? Rich than me wants to be taken. Twin sisters.
Okay. I guess I'll make another, you know, news, Channel 4 or whatever. But anyways, our hero who has just come from Florida, and I guess we could tell the whole world down in St. Louis. Here's a bus driver. Okay, but anyways, when we get to St. Louis, the news company will be for the news.
Well, we finally made it home, and look at this crowd, New Tower Grove, just coming in from Tampa, Florida. It reminds me of when we used to have to load up and go to the cotton field.
God bless you, brother.
All right, same here.
If y'all ever want to see some water, call me up.
All right. You all be careful on your next trip out.
I sure will.
All right.
I'll see you Monday.
Okay.
Maybe tomorrow night, I don't know yet.
Well, he likes to want
something. My mama did it first.
What channel is your mom?
They got here first.
And here comes the rescue team.
Okay, look at me. Hi. We love you. What's her name? I think it is. I see you, but I can't remember your name.
Who's that?
Who you telling her name? Who you telling her name?
Oh, her name, Aunt Laura, I love you. Hi, love you, and hi, bye.
This one is your
house. I feel like it. Come on. Here. Hi.
You only got your key in front door?
Back door, yes.
The front door?
Yes, I have. Hello, okay.
Hey, bro.
What's up, Captain?
How you doing?
All right.
Watch out, that white folk talk now.
Hello, how are you?
Hello, Maisha. Go tell your grandma.
Again, good afternoon. First, giving praises to my Heavenly Father, to the President,
yes,
to our National President, to our moderators, and to the Wallace family. We're going to have our procession. We're going to have scripture by Reverend Thomas McCormick. We're going to have prayer by Reverend E.A. Johnson. We're going to have the purpose by Sister Carrie Moore. And Sister Henderson, would you do us a favor, since you're the district president, Reverend Gladden's wife is not here, so we're going to ask you to march with him. And Sister Dottie will come and bring our candidates in.
All right.
Stand, please.
our Master,
yes,
our
Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
For giving us another chance to assemble ourselves together in the house of the Lord. We come tonight, O God, with bowed heads and our hearts to just say thank you. For we realize, O God, that you didn't have to bring us together again, but you did, and we are grateful. And now, Lord, you know our purpose here tonight. We pray that thou will lead and guide us.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Direct us in the way that you'd have us to go.
Yes.
That your name, not the president, but your name. Not the chairperson, but your name.
Your name
will be glorified above every name in this house tonight. And then, Lord, if there be an unsaved, or one who has strayed away, we pray, oh God, that they'll be reminded tonight to get in a hurry and come on the inside before the rain starts.
Yep.
Now, Lord, bless us and keep us as we go through this service. In Jesus' name we ask it all. Amen.
Amen.
To President Woods, to Second Vice President Hartsfield, to Moderator Johnson, Moderator McCormick, to my pastor, Reverend Cobbins, and to all of you, my brothers and sisters in the Lord, to the host pastor, Reverend Fletcher. What is our purpose here this week? Our purpose here this week is in the remembrance of our retreat center, to keep on the mind of the people what the use of the retreat center is. When I attended the National Baptist Convention Midwinter Board in Alexandria, Louisiana, a couple of weeks ago, Dr. Mays talked about equipping saints. And Dr. Mays talked about how much money the NFL used to train their players for a game. And he talked about taking it outside of the stadium in which the game is originally or ordinarily played. He said all of the training cannot be done on the field of the stadium, that there must be some time spent in the equipping the players for the game. There has to be a training room.
All right.
And he said in the training room, they would be in there lifting weights and building up their bodies for the game.
Yeah.
Now the retreat center can serve as that purpose for us if we would allow it to. Mm-hmm. Pastors, he also talked about getting out of the sanctuary with your classes and teaching and training saints and equipping saints for the battlefield and for getting out there and teaching and bringing in soul winning for Christ. Now the retreat centers, every once in a while, we're going to have to get out of our sanctuaries. It would be nice to take the brotherhoods out there to the retreat center for some quiet time with the Lord. It would be nice to be able to take a youth group out there to the retreat center to spend some quiet time with the Lord. Now that's a good getaway place. That's a good training place. We just have to utilize the retreat center. We are here to bring to you the forefront of some usage for our retreat center. It will only be what we make it be. We need to get in some training, classroom training. There is so much that we need to know that we cannot always get on Sunday morning in the sanctuary. So let's use the retreat center as our classrooms. And let's go out there and train the saints, equip the saints to do a better job for the Lord. And in order to do that, we must have the equipment out there. It would be a horrible thing to go to an exercise room and there is no equipment in the exercise room. We might as well stay at home. If the center is not going to be equipped for the need, then we might as well close the doors. We need to equip that center so that it can be used for the purpose in which we need it for. Now, my job is to say tonight that we need funds for the center. We are here to raise money for the center.
Yes.
It's a fundraiser. It is here to show off our beautiful pastor's wives, But the focus tonight is raising funds that we may do a better work for the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Again, we want to thank Sister Moore for that purpose. And we do need to utilize our retreat center. Now, I am here to present the Wallace family. Now, Professor Wallace is a member of New Tower Grove, St. Louis, Missouri, and his pastor is Reverend H.B. Smith, Jr. He's a father of 8 girls, 4 boys, 37 grandchildren, and 3 great-grandchildren. He is a musician and composer. His latest CD entitled By Faith can be found in the music stores.
All right.
His tribute to honor Dr. Martin Luther King can be found in the public schools. He has a kind and humble spirit. I now present to you, all the way from St. Louis, the Wallace family.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. First number, as you very well heard, is the prayer, God build thy great Jehovah. And he guided us all the way from St. Louis, safely.
All right.
Amen. Amen. And the next two selections will be His Yoke is Easy, led by Sister Beverly Govan, and Lift Her Up, led by Sister Laura Wallace.
All right.
God
get
that.
That
sounds right.
Oh,
You're running and running and running and running.
Beautiful job, and she was thinking about some of the songs that my father composed. Oh, yes, this is my daddy.
All right.
Some of the songs my father composed.
Yes.
It's the title of the actual album. And, this is one of the numbers that he performed. He composed, rather. So we're going to sing this tonight. Leading it is my other sister. The other two beautiful solos are my sisters as well. This is my older sisters as well. Sister Charlene, Charlisa Quillen. Amen.
Yeah.
I'm going that gives me strength from day to day. Yes, we
Oh, And He said you must believe it with your heart and confess the same with your mouth. And that person, Jody, there might be someone today that don't know. Amen. Salvation has only two conditions. Repentance and baptism. This is your hour. Why don't you come? Amen.